Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. Today, we're going to format an existing USB drive or USB stick and then mount it to and unmount it from the system. Stay around after that if you would like to see how to create a bootable USB drive from an ISO file that we have previously downloaded, but not from another machine or operating system we have available. So no Balena Echo on Windows 11 or Impression on Ubuntu. The fun is to do all of it straight from FreeBSD. I am using GNOME on this machine, but it will work on any desktop manager. Everything I'm showing will work from the terminal too, creating the USB drive, mounting, formatting and unmounting, except, of course, the graphical way of creating a USB drive from an ISO file. That's the reason I am using a desktop manager, so I can demonstrate this. I have an existing and already used USB stick that I want to prepare and use for this. To make a fresh start, let's format the USB stick. Connect the USB drive to your computer, wait a few seconds, and display the system log messages with the command dmessage. D-M-E-S-G. The most recent messages will show the details about the connected USB drive. You can see that in this case, the Kingston Data Traveler was connected as device DA0. DA stands for Direct Access. Your first USB drive will always be DA0. If you have multiple USB drives or external hard disk connected, this might be a different value. In that case, adjust any of the following commands to your situation. Just to be sure, you might even want to disconnect existing drives and disks to not accidentally format the wrong device. Erase all partition information. Type gpart destroy dash capital F forward slash dev forward slash da0. The dash F flag will execute the command without prompting for any form of confirmation, so be careful. Def da0 refers to the device we have identified earlier. Now create a new partition table in preparation for the new partition we will be creating next. Type gpart create dash s mbr forward slash def forward slash da0 and add the new partition. Gpart add dash t fat 32 forward slash def forward slash DA0. We are planning on using the FAT32 file system, and that should work well for my ISO files. Of course, you can use XFAT or UFS as well, but the steps for this will be slightly different. So far, with the commands, we have destroyed the existing partition information, then we have created a new partition table and a new partition. The last step is to create the file system so that it is usable for storing files by actually formatting it. Type the command new fs underscore ms dos dash capital L and then the label or the name of your drive, I will just use USB, capital F 32 forward slash def forward slash da0 s1. The dash L specifies the label of the drive and it will be visible in your file manager later on. Def da0 s1 specified the target partition. As this is a newly formatted USB drive, the first partition or slice is referenced. S1 means slice 1. Let's double check our work with the command gpart list forward slash dav forward slash da0. This will list the details on the partition layout. The partition we have just formatted, da0 s1, the file system type, and the actual storage capacity. To list the connected USB drives and file systems, type ls forward slash dav forward slash da asterisk. Now the USB drive is ready for use and it can be mounted. To mount the USB drive, type mount underscore msdos fs forward slash dav forward slash da0 s1 forward slash media forward slash USB. The last portion is the place where the drive will be mounted, called the mount point. This has to be an existing directory, and in this case I have simply created a directory USB under the media directory. Of course, you can use any mount point, just adjust the command. The drive is now mounted, and by navigating into the directory for the mount point, I can try to create a text file. If no errors are returned and I can display the directory contents, the drive is ready to use. Once you are done, you can unmount the drive with the command umount /media/USB or your mount point. Of course, in this case, because I'm using GNOME, I could also just open the file manager and eject the USB drive from there. I have downloaded the FreeBSD 14.1 ISO file from FreeBSD.org and placed it in the downloads directory. Get any ISO you want from wherever you want for this step. I am just using FreeBSD as an example. Unetbootin is a tool that creates bootable USB drives for installing various Linux distributions or system utilities. It allows users to create live USBs, and it can even download distributions directly. Although it is somewhat older now, and the list of distributions does not seem to be updated in a few years, for today's purpose, where we have an existing ISO file that we have downloaded ourselves, and that we want to turn into a bootable USB, it is perfectly fine. By the way, if you know of another graphical utility for FreeBSD, please let me know in the comments. I was unable to locate a proper alternative. Install it with the command sudo pkg install unetbootin. Note that unetbootin doesn't automatically mount the USB drive for us, so make sure your USB stick or drive is mounted before you start unetbootin so that it can be properly detected. Also, it has to be in the FAT file system, and that's exactly how we have formatted the USB drive in the earlier steps. First, I'm going to show an example where the USB drive is not mounted before starting unetbootin. Start the utility with the command sudo unetbootin. Besides just selecting an ISO file, unetbootin can automatically download a distribution for you, but the list appears to be somewhat old by now. Unetbootin's GitHub page has not been updated in a while, and its latest release is version 7.0.2, and that's what we have just installed. For example, the latest release of FreeBSD listed is 8, and for Fedora this is version 30. It doesn't matter, because all we want is a graphical utility that can turn the ISO into a bootable USB drive. You can browse to the ISO and then select the USB drive. Because the USB drive was not mounted before I started unetbootin, nothing will be available for selection. But when I mount the USB drive as instructed by unetbootin and start it, it will be available for selection. Click OK when ready to start the process. Once done, click Exit. To create the bootable USB drive from the ISO or from the command line or terminal, we can use the DD utility. DD is used for low-level copying and conversion of data between files or devices. This will be the fastest and easiest way to create your USB drive from an ISO file, and my guess is that once you have seen it and you know how it works, you won't feel the need for a graphical tool at all. The beauty of DD is that we don't even need to format the USB stick or mount it. Just stick the stick into your computer. The DD command directly writes the ISO image to the USB device at a block level, completely overwriting the existing file system and partitions. There's no need to delete anything beforehand or format the USB stick beforehand. Any existing data or format on the USB stick will be replaced by the contents of the ISO file. The command is also beautifully simple. Type sudo dd if equals and then the path to your ISO file of equals /dev/da0 bs equals 1M conf equals sync status equals progress. IF means input file, OF means output file. By using the status equals progress parameter, you will get some feedback of the progress. And if you don't specify this, it will be complete silence while you wait. Also, we have specified synchronous copying and a block size of 1 megabyte. Now you know how to format, mount and unmount a USB drive and how to make it bootable through the use of the graphical utility unetbootin, or you can make your life simple by just using the dd command from the command line. That's it. Hope it helped. And if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time. Bye.